Good afternoon, my dear student. Today, I am going to teach you that about the remaining portion from the chapter 2, Egyptian civilization. Last week, complete up to the different the occupation from the trade. Now, we will start from the art and culture. What is the art and culture? Art and culture, the first is about the sculpture. Now, what is the sculpture? Those are the statues are made by from the Egyptian peoples. These are the very famous in all over the world. And they made the statues from the, generally from the, those of the king or the pharaoh and the god, goddess, their statues are generally they are able to form. Sometimes they also make the different statues of the lion-headed peoples. These are the also the lion-headed god. They also make their different statues. Now the next point is about the paint. Those are the pottery. Pottery means the Egyptian peoples, they like to make or they prepare. These are the different type of utensils. Pots, these are the different, and they use the special type of clay that is called the stearite, and is a very famous, and also they color it in the outside by through the enamel, like a different type of chemical, that the color is not goes out easy from the pots and utensils. And the third is about the paintings. Egyptian peoples also they are very like to draw the paintings, and most of the paintings they draw from the life after the death. They about the life after death. It's after the life, that day, the what are the life what the people get about these things. They have to draw their most of the pictures. And some pictures they also depict from the other animals. And not only this, they are those are the before when they alive, that time only they prepare or decorate the tomb. That which one they have to be kept on the after their day, their death. What is the kept after their death? Next is the architecture. The Egyptian peoples are their architectural site are very famous for them. Their main architectural things that is the Great Pyramid of Giza. They are the main great architectural structure that are made in the Egyptian peoples. That is the largest pyramid, one of the largest pyramid in the world. That Great Pyramid in Giza and the Great Sphinx. What is Great Sphinx? The Great Sphinx that is the lion-headed. They are the half of the portion. The lion and the head only like the human beings. This type of the bodies are the architectural features are known as the Great Sphinx. And one more architectural features that is the Abu Simbel temple. You know what is the main features of this Abu Simbel temple? That this full temples are made to cut down by one single pieces and they create the full temple inside on it. So these are the great architectural features that made by the Egyptian people. And the next is about the religion. That the Egyptian peoples, they believe in the different god and goddess. And the different gods are they belong from the different purpose. Like the sun god, Ra, the sun god. The Osiris, the god of underworld. And the Nefrit, that the Anubis is the jackal-headed god. And the, those are the Ne, the mother god of Ra. And Sekhmet, the goddess of destruction. And the Osiris and Isis, these are the divine, the king seek also. So these are the different goddess names that they have to take them from Osir. And not only them, those are the nature god also, from them also they take the Osir. So why you have to write about the religion? That time you have to write the state matter. In one side, you have to write the god name and the side for which purpose. Suppose I am giving the example that the Ra is a god. So in another side first, which one is a god? This side you have to write the Ra and another side the gods for which purpose? You have the sun. So by this way you have to write these things. That's about the reason. Now the next is what is the one of the special unique features in Egyptian civilization, that is the mummification. You know what is the mummification? That already I discussed while when I start this chapter. That mummification is a process of warping the dead body due to the linen cloths. It's known as the mummification. What is mummification? That warping of the dead bodies by to the linen cloths is known as the mummification. And what is mummy? The preserved dead bodies are known as the mummies. And next is about the what is salt. The was simply warping the dead bodies by to the linen cloths and covering with a sheet. That is known as the salt. The dead bodies they have to cover with a sheet. That is called the salt. And also what is the sarcophagus? The mummy was placed within a stone coffin. The mummy was placed within a stone coffin. That is called the sarcophagus. And on the time, the Egyptian peoples are very famous about their, from the science and the other side also. They are very famous for the achievement portion also. What are the things they achieved by the Egyptian people? The first is the papyrus, the paper. You know the papyrus is the name of a tree. that it's generally cultivated in the beside the River Nile or the bank of River Nile. And from the leaves of this tree, the people pass invent to make the paper. And this is the great achievement for the Egyptian people. And the second great achievement is the hieroglyphics writing. That, as you know, this is one of the unique features. Like the Western people, their writing system is known by the name of cuneiform. Like the same way, the Egyptian peoples, their writing system is known by the name of hieroglyphics. So this is also one of the achievements for the Egyptian people. And the third is the calendar. The Egyptian peoples first, they made the solar calendar. And in a year, they have 12 months. And each month have the 30 days. And in year, it occurs within 365 days. These all the things that today also we have to follow that are made by through the Egyptian people only. So this is one of the greatest achievements for the Egyptians. And the next is about the medicine. The Egyptian peoples, not only these things, about the before that, the peoples not knew about the medicine also. That what are the, if they suffer from any diseases, they are not cured from any type of disease about the medicine they are not able to apply. But the Egyptian peoples, they first use the different type of medicines. And they invent also the medicine for the different diseases. Almost the 40 of medicine they have to invent for the different diseases. So this is one of the achievement also for them. And the last is the astronomer. Astronomer means those peoples, they can say about the future. This subject, that is called the astronomer. Or those peoples, they are in this subject, we know about, we study about our future. How to know about our future. This subject is known as the astronomy, and those peoples, they have to study this subject, they are known as the astronomer. So on that time, the peoples, they have to be very famous on this subject about the astronomy. So this is very important achievements for them. So what are the achievements that are made by the Egyptian people? First is the papyrus or the paper invention. Second is the hieroglyphic writing. Third is the invention of calendar. Fourth is the invention of medicine. And the fifth is the astrology. Astronomy. And next is the reason for the declination. Now, what are the reasons that this civilization is going to be declined? That the many reasons are responsible for that. You know what are the reasons? The first one is that after the Ramesses II, Ramesses III, when the last ruler of Egypt, when after his ruling, that weak successor, all the rulers, those who came, they are very weak in nature. So they cannot able to manage the whole civilization. So civilization is going to be declined. So what is the first point? Weak successor. Then after the Ramesses III, those are the successors they sit on the throne of Egypt. They are not capable to maintain the whole civilization. So this civilization is going to be declined. What is the second point? About the continuously flood. So we know that in Nile River, every year, that is a flood is occurring. And the peoples, all the areas, both the side of the river bank, they are the houses and the many peoples getting died every year. So due to this flood also, this is one of the reasons that peoples leave the place and they went into the another place. And the third is the change the river direction. Due to the natural calamities, the river can sometimes, the river start to flow into another direction. So those are the peoples, they are living beside the river. They leave the place and they went into the new place. And the last is the foreign invasion. And the many peoples or the many foreigners, they want to conquer this region. So for this foreign invasion also, the land masses will be covered or conquered by the other peoples. And it will be difficult for the person also. So it's one of these are the four, one of the reasons for the declination of Egyptian civilization. So what are the reasons? First one is the weak successor. Second is the flood. Third is the change in river direction. Fourth is foreign invasion. This four point you have to write with their description. So you can understand these are the reasons for the declaration of Egyptian civilization. Now you see that in the exercise portion that is given, first is the fill in the blanks. The flood water of the Nile brought rich which soil? It's the alluvium soil. Second is the people in debt were also reduced to the slavery. What is the slavery? Next is the Das was the Pharaoh chief advisor. Who was the Pharaoh chief advisor? We know that one is the vizier, was the Pharaoh chief advisor. Fourth, the people who were wealthy wore the sandals that made up by the leather. Next, the most of the painting recovered that relate to the life after day. Means the most of the painting they made due to the life after day. Next, the true false. The Assyrian Egyptian did not believe in life after day. That is the false because they believe about this matter. The vizier was responsible for the overseeing the administration, and all official document had to be a seal of approval. This is the true. And the women of the upper class ran the household. That is the true also. The Egyptian lined their eyes with the coal for the considered fashionable. No response. Because they used the coal for their which purpose? To protect their eyes from the hard sun rays and also from the sand dust. And the Egyptian artists used the vertical and horizontal reference to line to maintain their proportion to their work. Is that true? They have to use these things, vertical and horizontal line, to make their statue or the drawing is made perfect. And number C, the person responsible for making laws and keeping order in the kingdom, who is the person? It's the pharaoh or king. The pharaoh chief advisor is known as the vizier. People who could read and write, they are known as the scribes. What is the name? Scribes. The longest serving female ruler, that is the Hatshepsut. Hatshepsut is the longest serving female ruler in Egyptian civilization. And the most significant part of the Egyptian attribute is the elaborate headdresses. Elaborate headdresses is the answer for that. And this, so your homework is on this chapter, that this past A, B, C from the exercise, you have to write down in your copy with the question with answer properly. And your homework is number D. This chapter 2, number D, all the question answer. Number D from 1 to 7, you have to be right. From the 1 to 7, you have to complete it. Number D, 1 to 7 is your homework. So you have to, I hope you have to complete in your copy with the question with answer problem. So today I'll be here. Next day we'll start the analysis.